So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Andrew. We have a motion and a second.
I do have a change to the agenda. On page 5, under item 15, number 3, we're removing the name Amanda Crouch. That's all.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Marshall. Okay, where are we here? If there's no second, we will need a vote, yes.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Thank you. Okay, motion carries. Next is the agenda. Next thing on the agenda is the election of officers for calendar year 2017. I would like to open up nominations for president. May I have your nominations, please?
I nominate Mr. Andrew Wilson to serve as president of the board for calendar year 2017.
And I second that.
Thank you, Mrs. Luce. Thank you, Mr. Browning. Are there any other nominations for president? Hearing none, may I have a motion to close the nominations for president?
So moved.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Luce. Thank you, Mrs. Malad. Ms. Luce. Okay. Any discussion from the board at this time?
Mr. Wilson has done a great job for us through the last year, and through his leadership, we were able to come as far as we have this year. We passed our bond this year. We have really been on a roll, and I would really like to see that leadership.
Any other discussions?
Well, what?
Hearing no more discussion, we will vote. Mrs. Marshall?
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. Mrs. Marshall, would you please call the roll for the vote of electing Mr. Andrew Wilson to serve as our president for calendar year 2017?
Yes. Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Mrs. Malott?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Wilson. You are declared the president, and congratulations. Now we will open up the nomination for vice president. May I have your nominations, please?
Yeah, I would like to nominate Katie Malott for vice president for this next calendar year.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Ms. Luce. Any other nominations? Hearing none, may I have a motion to close the nominations for vice president?
So moved.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson. Thank you, Mr. Browning. Any discussion from the board?
I just wanted to comment that the past year of the board, Katie's done a great job for us, and I think it's very important that we also move some of the leadership positions between various members of the board. So I'm looking forward to her being vice president. I think she'll do a great job this coming year.
Any other discussions? Hearing none, we will vote. Mrs. Marshall?
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. Mrs. Marshall, would you please call the roll to vote on electing Katie Malott as our vice president for calendar year 2017.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mrs. Malott?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes.
Thank you, and thank you, Mrs. Malott. You are declared the vice president, and again, congratulations. Mrs. Marshall, would you please swear in Mr. Wilson and Mrs. Malott for their roles as president and vice president of the Fairborn City Schools Board of Education.
Do you solemnly swear to support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of Ohio, and to be faithful to the Constitution
Me too.
Congratulations, Mr. Wilson and Mrs. Malad. And as President Pro Temp, and at this time, I would like to turn the meeting over to our newly elected president, Mr. Andrew Wilson.
Thank you, Mr. McCord. The first item on the agenda for us is the organizational section where we appoint various board members to represent committees and various other things that are listed in item 7. I'd also like to take this time to recognize Mr. Mike Eaker in the audience, who is serving as our liaison to the Greene County Career Center. Previous board member.
And it's my understanding you're the vice president for that board this year?
I am. We're a complete lapse in judgment.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
And thank you for wanting to serve as the liaison for Fairborn. Any other comments? Any discussion from any of the board members on the...
Do you want to do a motion first?
Okay. A motion to appoint the listed members for the organizational meeting.
Second.
Mr. Brown? Okay. Any discussion? Desired? Comments?
Yes. Is everybody happy?
Absolutely. Okay. Are we good?
Yeah.
All right.
Good.
All right.
Vote.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. Treasurer's office.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Malone.
And so the first item on the agenda is to authorize the treasurer request tax advances for 2017. We request tax advances from Greene and Montgomery County auditors, which lets us get our money a little bit sooner. And the approving the annual tax budget that's in your agenda.
And Heckler office, that is the headquarters office. We can deal with the attorneys that are out of the office.
Right, yes. Well, and we deal with some out in Columbus. My bond counsel attorney is out of Columbus. Our regular attorney is here tonight. Mr. Lampy, he's out of the day office.
So. Any questions or comments? Call the roll, please.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Mrs.
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Superintendent's office. List of various items here on item 9. We have a motion.
So moved.
Mr. McCourt?
Second.
Mr. Brown? Mr. North?
You know, each item is a standard item that's required as part of this meeting, and there's nothing unusual or unique about it.
Call the roll, please.
Mr. McCord?
Yes.
Here. Mr. Brown?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mrs. Malak?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Item 10. Move to the regular meeting. It is requested that the board move to their regular meeting. May I have a motion?
So
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. McCord.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Cruz.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. Item 11, chromosomes. Superintendent's report, Mr. Norris.
Actually, I have three items tonight, and I apologize, but I forgot to put Mike down for the report from the Green County Career Center, so if it's okay with the board, I'd like to go ahead and start with Mike.
Absolutely.
The board on what's going on up at the Career Center.
I'd be glad to. All right, thank you very much. Again, thank you for the privilege of representing our community, our school district. As far as what's going on at the Career Center, many of you may not know, everybody else had a two-hour delay yesterday. We had the entire day off. And I know exactly why, because I got to watch this spectacular fireworks show on 235 in Enid last night as the power lines went down and the transformers blew up. So they had no power whatsoever until about 1 to 2 o'clock yesterday afternoon. So just but everything's back online, and they're in the midst of recovery here. As far as normal business is concerned, I told you that we're doing the study right now to determine what we're going to do in terms of refurbing or replacing our facilities. Because of all the HVAC problems and leaky roofs and everything else, working with the OSFC, it's going to cost about $25 million to refurb the current facility. We're looking, in conjunction with the Take Flight Initiative and upgrading our technology, it would cost, given the fact that the OSFC would supply us, we think, about 50% of our funding required if we do this right. A new facility costs $50 million. Of which they'd supply 25. Refurbing would cost 25, of which they'd supply 1.7. We're sort of leaning towards that, but we're still in the early throes of it. We may actually be able to get away with this without going out for a bonded levy because of some things that we've been doing. As far as new programs coming down the line, we have this fall we're going to introduce three new programs. A sports and exercise science as part of the physical education program out there. We have a Career X program that we are initiating, which is aimed towards the more challenged students. We specializing in getting them ready with soft skills to find a place in society after graduation. And the third one is, and that's the first program in this area. The closest career center that has this particular program ongoing is down in Warren County. So we're doing that. The third one is an engineering technology program that we're going to start up. It'll be a satellite program out of Beaver Creek High School. And depending on how well we can get that started and running, that may become a model and a pilot for the other schools in the district, provide them with career center-oriented engineering technical education. Let's see, there is, those were the three ones, as I said, somebody asked me earlier about the jet that was donated to Beaver Creek High School. Right now, we've re-engaged with Beaver Creek and with the folks out of the airport with the jet to what are we going to do about it? There is some potential that we will actually take a portion of that aircraft. They'll actually take the aircraft, cut it into three different chunks, use one for a cockpit and familiarization, sort of a think of it as the Oscar Mayer wiener. They're going to put it on wheels and carry it around to the different schools throughout the county as here is what aerospace really means. So people can get their hands on, see what an aircraft looks like from the inside, get a chance maybe to play with the controls and get them interested in that sort of a career. second part of the aircraft, the midship, if you will, landing gear, engines, take that, and that becomes part of an AMP mechanics technology education, which is something that the people down in Wilmington are screaming about. There are several thousand AMP mechanics short of what they could do. And for those of you who don't know what an AMP mechanic, aircraft and airplane and power plant, those are mechanics. They're airplane mechanics. With an AMP certification, they do really, really well financially. And the good news is, once you get your AMP certification, first of all, if we can give them most of that education before they graduate, it costs them very little. They can have a certification, a job, and no loan payments, which is kind of a cool thing in this day and age. The last part of the aircraft, the empennage, if you will, the tail, they're thinking about using that, putting it out, making it a sign out at the Greene County Airport, because a lot of those classes will probably take place out at the airport itself. So that's what's going on. We are very busy, looking forward to the start of the second semester. And I did forward to the superintendent the January newsletter, and because I was in a hurry and didn't really feel like I didn't get all of your email addresses, so I asked him if he would forward it to you. So you all should be getting that in the next day or two.
Yes.
With that, if there are no questions, that completes my presentation.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next item I have, we have the overhead ready for policy.
You want to do policy next?
If you're ready. I'm going to ask the board to move over here so you can see the screen. We've had discussions lately regarding revising our district policies. Our district policy was the last time as an entire policy manual been revised was 2003. Now it's been updated in parts, bits and pieces, but it's time. It's time to do a complete overhaul. We did comparisons with agencies that offer this kind of work, and I recommended to the Board of Education that we use NEOLA, which is a change because we currently used OSBA. Just for the audience, I'm understanding that NEOLA specializes in putting together and updating, revising policies. That's all they do. In addition to that, it's all they do for over 550 school districts in the state. So they do the policies for the majority of the school districts in the state. And that's not to say anything negative in regards to OSBA's job. They do a fine job also. But as I share with the board, there's a couple of things that I like about the NEOLA policy. One is everything is in a is numbered rather than alphabetical. And that may not seem like a big deal, but when you're dealing with a policy book that's 6 inches thick and you get into numbers like BDKK-A, it starts to get a little confusing, where the number system of policy is 7314, and it makes it much easier, clearer to define policies you need. The other thing, the reason why you see Lebanon up here, it's not because I forgot where I'm at, but it's the most recent experience I've had working with NEOLA. So we're going to use it as an example. And simply what will happen is you take Lebanon from there and you put the
Fairborn Skyhawk logo up there and pretend this is our website with the Fairborn Skyhawk. Anybody, whether it's a board member, administrator, staff member, parent, community member, if you're a resident and you're living in Phoenix, Arizona, you go to our website and you simply would click on Board of Education, and the next thing you would do is click on School Bylaws and Policies. Yes, please. Now click on to view. And here you will find what our policies will look like. And this is the number system I'm talking about. Anything to do with the board's bylaws is click back. Under zeros, anything has to do with administration, under 1,000, anything to do with programs, 200, professional staff, 3,000, and so on. So one of the things that you may have a question about programs, maybe something like College Career Plus. So one of the things you can do is you can click on the programs, please click on the programs, please. And you can look down through there and you can see that in 2271 is the district's policy on College Career Plus. You can click on that and anybody in the world can see what the policy is on College Career Plus. If you go ahead and back up again to the list. Let's say you have the same topic, College Career Plus, but you just don't know what it would fall under. If you type in under search, College Career Plus, there it is again, 2217. So it's just a very, very simple system for anybody to use. As I said, board members, parents, taxpayers, anybody that has access to a computer will be able to pull very quickly, very easily, our policies. And the other thing that goes along with this is we also will have our administrative guidelines that will be updated and will go along with the policies. And the other thing that happens is that Neola will send a rep who lives here in the area out to our school system twice a year, every year, to make sure that as the laws change, the federal guidelines change, anything on the state or federal level, or if there's something that happens in a school district in the state where they create a policy, they will come out and work with our director of student services and work through those revisions and so that we can keep those updated ongoing every year, and we'll do that twice a year. They also send them policies. Like I said, if something comes up just out of the blue, they'll stop in and bring those policies in and go over those with us so we can keep our policies current. There's the difference in cost, I believe, between the OSBA service and Neola is about a $9,000 difference, but I honestly believe with Neola specializing only in policies, laying out a system that's very, very convenient, easy, and understandable for everybody. It's certainly money well spent in regards to our staff looking at our policies, or even the public looking at policies, so that we can be completely transparent in how we do our business. Any questions regarding the revision of policies and how this will work? If not, then we can move back.
Just before we leave that, Mark, there have been a number of comments from people in the community about it being difficult to find our policies and procedures. So I think what Mark just showed is extremely important to get them out there where people can find them easily and you know, transparency in what we're trying to do. So I think that's great.
Thank you. One last thing tonight before you leave, we sessions. These work sessions, unfortunately, I'm sorry, but, you know, like most organizations, they work during the day. And so we have dates on the 18th, 19th, as well as February 2nd. And we have one date that's not scheduled yet. But if any board members would like to make these sessions, the AM session 3 and 4, the PM session 3 and 4, we have administrators that have signed up to volunteer. I'm probably going to ask administrators to sign up for one more round, so volunteering for two sessions. And please write your name beside the beside where it says board member for any of these sessions you'd like to attend and work on. And glad to see you there. Just make sure that there's been more than two, or the work session will turn into a board meeting.
Right.
Last thing that we have on the agenda is a recognition of board members. I don't know if you're aware of this, but January is the Ohio School Board Association's recognition month of school board members. And I've always said this, I've been a superintendent now for over 20 years, and I'm very sincere in saying there's three positions or jobs that I have no interest of ever holding. One is a basketball official, because no matter what call you make, half the people are telling you it's wrong. Two is a bus driver, because I found it difficult enough to stand in front of a classroom of 30 kids. There's no way I want to have my back 50 or 60. And three is a board member, because you do a tremendous amount of work and never receive any credit. But you certainly, and as you know, in volunteering and running for these positions, do hear when people have concerns to share. So we would like to, the Central Office Administrative Team would like to just take a moment to say on behalf of all those that do recognize the value and energy and the time and commitment that each one of you put in. And you know, this goes across the boards, across the state, career center boards, local boards. We just want to say thank you. So with that said, each one of our staff, central office administrators, has a presentation to make to each one of the board members. So, Sue, do you want to go ahead and start? You're good.
Thank you very much.
Five board members to move together so we can get a picture.
Recognition of visitors. In order for the board to fulfill its obligation to complete the planned agenda in an effective and efficient fashion, a maximum of 30 minutes of public participation may be permitted at each meeting. Each person addressing the board shall give his or her name and address, and state the purpose for addressing the board, and we'll allow 3 minutes until our third per person until 30 minutes is used.
Thank you, Andy.
Thank
Marilyn McCauley, Fairborn City Councilwoman. I bring you greetings from the city. Just a couple little minor items tonight. Obviously, we're going through the city manager search. The due date has been met. It has been closed off, so our search firm has been collecting all the applicants. He will do his due diligence and then send the final five or thereabouts onto the council for final selection. There most likely will be a open social evening for the community, probably towards the end of February, for the community to come meet the candidates. Right before then, we make our final selection. So keep watching the paper, and hopefully you'll be participating in those community events. The other night at our work session, somebody brought up the idea, my goodness, when the school gets their new school down there at Five Points, we're going to have those ugly water towers out there with this new school building. And we kind of laughed and sat there a minute, and we go, well, it's not easy to move water towers. So what the city's going to do, and I think Mr. North knows about this, but at least when you finalize your design on the outside as far as to making it look pretty, shrubs and all that sort of thing, we're going to try to carry that on over around the water towers to at least make them look a little friendly. So we're doing all we can with a couple big old water towers. So anyhow, we've kept the schools in mind and tried to tag up with the school building and make the whole area look nice. So we're going to try to do that anyhow. Anybody have any questions? What's going on in the city?
Well, I'll chime in and say good luck with that search. Having gone through that about a year ago to find a superintendent, it is not an easy process.
We are all bracing for those applicants to come in early February because we're told there are probably 100 pages of information each. So having said that, we're all bracing, clearing our calendars of anything else for early February. So. Anything else?
Google is your friend.
Do what?
I said Google is your friend.
Okay, cool. Well, hopefully the search firm has done a lot of that.
Well,
but
we'll find out even more.
Okay, cool.
Thank you. Good luck, Marilyn.
Thanks, Marilyn.
Thank you.
Good evening, Donna Wilson, 442 Zimmer Drive. Right now, as you know, the new president-elect is forming his cabinet, representatives, the head of them. And the one I want to speak about tonight is the Secretary of Education. The committee hearing will begin. It was supposed to have begun yesterday, but it's been delayed, and I don't know when it will start. But it is critical that we express our strong concerns regarding her nomination. She has never been a public school advocate. She has never attended a public school. Her children have not attended public schools. She does not know the issue and the importance of the public school system. And I am here to ask you to oppose the nomination. And the way you can do that, and if you want to go and find out any information on Betsy DeVos, you can find it. One of the things that the Ohio Elections Commission found was that the federal and Ohio All Children Matter, which was an organization started by her, is a PAC, and it violated Ohio campaign laws. She was fined $5.3 million, but this has never been paid. So she owes $5.3 million to the state of Ohio. She pushes for-profit charter schools and online schools which consistently fail the students they are supposed to serve. Now, Fairborn sends out about $3 million to go with students who go to charter schools, and very few of these charter schools do as well as the Fairborn public schools or better. Very few. We also have, as you know, the Black Lane online school or virtual academy. I'm not sure the exact name of it. But they have people there. Those students have to come there. And they, a certain number of times, they have a director, they have counselors, they have teachers to help them, rather than just letting them stay at home and maybe go online for how many minutes. They're supposed to be online for 5 hours a day, but very few of them do. So I hope that the way you can oppose this, one way you can oppose it, is to send an email to your representative, or not your representative, your senators, Brown and Portman. And also, there are phone numbers that you can call. There are 23 senators, federal senators, on the committee. And Andy and I each called all 23 of them to oppose the nomination of her. And it took us about 40 minutes total each. So if you would just call two or three of them, it would be great. I have the numbers. If anyone wants a list of the numbers of the committee members, I have those. So this is really important. We need to have local control over our schools. No one knows our students like we do. And someone who pushes charter schools to get students away from us with that, and taking the money, the little money that we have, and then not giving it back, is not doing our children a service at all. So I'm hoping that you will try to take a few minutes of your time and call a couple of these committee members. They have had, I think I saw 98,000 emails come in, and I don't remember how many phone calls, but there is a lot of opposition to it. And that's the only way we can change anything with the way things are now. Thank you.
We'll close recognition of visitors. And now move on to item 13.
Okay.
Approve the minutes of the Thursday, December 1st, 2016 regular meeting. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. McCord.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. Okay, item 14, the Treasurer's Report.
November 30th, 2016, month-end financials. Last month we went over, okay. Overall revenues are lower for the year. We have a large decrease in our other operating revenue, which was expected. It's due to the large back claiming that we got last year from the Medicaid reimbursements. So we were expecting that large decrease in that line item. And again, our state funding is up, as it has been throughout the year. Overall, we had received 44.94% of what's been forecast to be received for the year. Our expenses as of November are $149,000 lower than the prior year at the same time. This is mostly due to timing. We did have a decrease in retirement benefits that I've talked about due to a refund we got from the state employees retirement system that I've coded as a reduction of an expense rather than a revenue so that's affected that number. We also received some workers' compensation rebates. It's also being coded as a reduction of an expense. And our capital outlay, that's much lower this year than it was at the same time last year. I do expect that number to increase throughout the year as we move to online testing, which we will be doing this year. Dr. Brackenhoff has confirmed, so we need for that number to go up as things are being implemented with that. Overall, we had spent 40.19% of the total forecast amount for the month of November. Our fund balance at the end of November was $20.2 million. We had outstanding encumbrances of $5.2 million, with an unencumbered balance of around $15 million. That's $5.6 million higher than it was at the same time last year. This shows our running total cash balance in the general fund just each month compared to the same time last year. And this is just a graph of that. As of November 30th, we had about $22.3 million in average expenses per month for salaries and benefits, a little over $1 million in average expenses for everything else. With a total of about $3.5 million. Our number of certified employees, including substitutes, was 346, and our number of classified employees, including substitutes, was 286, and that's as of the end of November. And that number fluctuates throughout the year. Total investments, we had about $20.7 million, and this is all funds. There wasn't a lot of change from the month of October in investments to November. Our cash reconciliation, not a lot of change here. We reconciled to zero. We had a little over $4,000 sent in our payroll parents account. That's all I have. Is there any questions from the board?
Mrs. Marshall, I'd like to add a little tidbit of this that I saw recently is that the Fairborn City Schools is the third largest employer in the city of Fairborn, behind obviously Wright State University, which is number two, and BASE. And 600 employees, and those are by and large very well educated, very hardworking, dedicated individuals that we have working. Okay, move on to item 15, the consent agenda, which runs through page 8. A variety of personnel office, business office, and student services office items. I'd like to call your attention to page 8, the item 8 at the top of page 8. Which is resignations and retirements of classified employees. We have two individuals with long-time service with City of Fairborn City Schools, Bruce Porter, clinic assistant. I request a resolution of tribute for 19 years of service for Fairborn City Schools, and Benita Regal, bus driver, retirement, resolution of tribute for 29 years.
Wilson?
Yes.
If I may add, number 10, I'd just like to take a moment to point out that with the approval of this job description, and we've had this information to board for quite some time now, the purpose of that is so that we can go ahead and post for a second. We have one technology coordinator, and this would job description is the purpose of now posting second technology coordinator. The change in the job description is that the technology coordinator would either have an associate degree or equivalent work experience. One of the big reasons for this is, as Nicole just mentioned, the school district is going to have to switch from a paper pencil state test to all of our students using technology in order to get the state test, and that's
better word than Osgood. It's a scary transition. It's overwhelming. In addition to that, frankly, and I've shared this week, we're comparing with similar districts. We're understaffed in that area. And we have, and the way that we have, are able to pay for this without spending more money is we've looked at places where we do attrition in other departments and line up the staffing to be comparable to similar districts. And so by doing that, utilizing attrition and then one other department, we're able to add this position without any additional cost. And it's certainly much needed.
Thank you. A motion for approval of the consent agenda, please.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Ms. Luce. Any additional discussion?
I'd just like to point out to the board, just because I don't think I had a chance to mention this beforehand, is we are increasing our classified substitute rate effective January 1st to correspond with the federal minimum wage.
Also, Mr. Wilson, if I may just make a comment, one of my retirements in Bruce Porter, a family that's been in this community for years and years. I went to school with Bruce's older brother, and he was still younger than me, but Bruce and his family, of course, and his mom and dad were just great people in our community. Bruce hung around here and was a big part of not only what goes on in our school buildings, but also as coaching. I remember some of our youth soccer kids years ago as well. So it's always good to see people reach retirement age that are wanting to retire. And I just wish the best and all for Bruce and his family. And congratulations, I think, on those 18 or 19 years he had. Thank you.
Anyone else? Call the roll, please.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. McQuirt?
Yes.
Mrs. Milan?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Item 16, Treasurer's Office. Okay, a variety of approvals, bond resolutions. Is that, may I have a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Mrs. Milan.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Browning. Discussion?
Yes. So, item A, you guys are familiar. Item B is the Section 125 Flexible Benefit Plan. We update this every calendar year. It's for IRS regulations so that we can offer benefits to our employees on a pre-tax basis. Item C is a depository agreement with Fifth Third Bank. That's the bank that we bank with. It actually expired in February. So we are retroacting it back to February of 2016. It should have been approved back then. I apologize for that. And D and E are our bond resolutions, so we can pay for our new buildings. Which we're very excited about
thing.
That. Yes.
Any discussions, comments? Call the roll, please.
Ms. Milan?
Yes.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. McQuirt?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Item F, approve resolution to waive delinquent property taxes for a parcel that the city has taken over. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. McQuirt.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Milan. Mm-hmm. Comments?
Yeah, the city's been really busy lately with development. So this is another, we've seen this on the last couple of board agendas. I've asked Andy to abstain because of this conflict of interest with the city. He's married to a councilwoman, so.
I'd like to make one comment. I think, you know, when the members of the new board came on, we made a vow and a pledge that we wanted to really work with our city a lot closer. I think if you were to talk to some of the city people and talk to the board members, we have done exactly that, and we want to continue to do that. Marilyn, I'm awful glad to see her coming to our meetings, and I try to get to some of the city meetings as well, but And it's always good to see Donna here too, but I think we can say we're probably working with this city better than we ever have, that I can remember, and you know, I go back a ways, but and from all the information I know. So, I mean, I really do appreciate that, and you know, I think we've got to remember, the school goes, the city goes, this is all a team effort, and we're all trying to do it for the best, I know, the city, for the members of this community, and of course, I hope we never forget on this side of it who we work for, and that's the kids. So I do appreciate it.
Call the roll, please.
Yes. Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Mrs. Malott?
Yes.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Abstain. Motion carries. Item 17, gifts and donations. Didn't write it down.
So. It's all right. Okay. I'm going to read off the gifts and donations for which we are always very appreciative. Scott and Rhonda Lilly have donated $50 for the senior class trip to New York. Chris Manchin, Division of Wildlife for Greene County, has donated an archery box for the archery club valued at approximately $500. And the Hall of Honor donations for this month, Jennifer Ann Sexton and Elaine K. Lytle, $50. White donor in memory of Al and Phyllis Misley, and Bruce Lamar, $250 silver donor in memory of Al Misley.
Okay, I have a motion.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning. I'll second it.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. New business, Board of Education. Various agreements to approve here. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Malott. Discussion?
Sinclair Community College agreement puts parent counselor one day a week at the high school. Free.
Well, that's nice.
That's always good.
Yeah.
Free. We have an agreement between the Fairborn City Schools International Mailing System. That is for a postage machine at the board office. We're going with a local company. It's a better price, hoping better service. Our license agreement with Neola that Mr. Norton presented. And then we have two contracts with Strategic Management Solutions. Strategic Management Solutions is a third-party contractor that helps us through the E-rate process. There's been so many changes with the E-rate process. We get a lot of money refunded to us through E-rate for technology things and wireless and internet and all that. And so we'll work with them in order to get all the paperwork filed and all that, the technology part of it.
So Mrs. Brackenhoff's message right. On that potential that could reimburse us nearly completely for
right.
All right.
Upgrades.
And just touch base on the way they're paid also, if you would. It's like 5% of...
They actually run it through the ITC site mm-hmm. that they actually reduce our bill based on right. Whatever we're... And it changes, and I'm looking at Mr. Gibbons. I'm not sure what the percentage this year is for E-rate.
80%.
It's 80% this year.
Things that save us money are always good.
Yeah. Well, and help us out with all of the paperwork process that would be involved.
It's a lot of paperwork. Yes.
Call the roll, please.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Mrs. Malott?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Item F, first reading of fringe benefits for non-represented classified staff, effective July 1st, 2016. Is that supposed to be a vote on that?
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
So this is just the first reading. We'll have a vote
next time.
Right.
On the next board meeting. And I can read this out loud if you'd like.
Sure. Yeah, it's short.
It's a short paragraph. fringe benefits for non-represented staff unless otherwise stated in a staff member's employment contract, fringe benefits for classified staff members not covered by the terms in a currently valid collective bargaining agreement shall be determined by the collective bargaining agreement between the Board of Education and the Fairborn Classified Employees Association and the recommendation of the superintendent or treasurer as applicable. So basically what that says is for purposes of fringe benefits, the classified staff is not represented. We'll follow the FCEA agreement.
And not subject to a contract.
Right.
Right.
And that's how it's been handled historically. Here, is we just haven't had a formal policy for it.
Okay, we'll move to board member good of the order. I'd like to thank Mr. McCourt for presiding as president pro tem of the initial portion of the meeting. So we'll start with Mr. McCourt.
Thank you, Andy. First of all, I would just like to maybe make people aware of that our best wishes go out to Jennifer Whiting. Mrs. Whiting took a spill at Wright Elementary the other day when the parking lot was so icy, and she'd been off work here for a couple weeks, I guess, and she's getting better. I did talk with her mother, and she's doing a lot better, and I think she's due back to work maybe next week. I guess the situation, she got out of her car, took a couple steps and tumbled, and then our maintenance superintendent was there, and so he helped her up and he tumbled. So it was a bunch of people sliding downhill, I guess, out there, but I hope she gets better. Secondly, in my packet tonight, I received a nice letter from a gentleman by the name of Gabe. All of us board members, or a lot of the board members, went out and helping with the family night with the kids. So I got a nice little thank you note from Gabe, and to Gabe, I appreciate you thinking of me, and know that we are always thinking of you. So thank you for that. Also, during my time off here, my wife did me a wonderful thing by buying me a new knee for Christmas. So I've been taking a few weeks off here trying to recover from knee surgery. But to the Board of Ed down in Whittier, thank you for the beautiful flowers that were sent out to me. And thanks for the many cards I've received from folks, you know, just inquiring as to that. So thank you again. You know, I watch TV a lot, and being that I'm kind of bedridden or recliner-ridden, I should say. But, you know, it seems like every week we're seeing bus drivers, buses in accidents, people hitting buses sliding off streets and everything. So I would just like to thank all of our bus drivers who do that work, and I hope and pray that they are very careful, which I know they are, because they are carrying quite a bit of good baggage for us. So to all the bus drivers, we thank you for what you do. And again, you know, I hope we can get through this winter accident-free. And also for the gifts that I received tonight, thank you to the Board of Education. And I appreciate it, and thank you, Andy. Ms. Luce.
I'd like to just take a minute to piggyback on what Mr. North said about School Board Recognition Month. And this month marks the one-year anniversary for Katie and Jerry and Pat to be on the board. And I just want to thank them so much for this last year and how hard they've worked and how much they have greatly improved Andy and I's life in the last year. Can't say enough about that. You all know what I'm talking about. It's been great. This has been the best board ever to work with. And we just couldn't ask for anything better. And on behalf of Andy and I, I'd like to thank them for everything they've done, and here's two more great years. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mr. Browning.
Hey, I want to start actually the same thing with the Fairborn primary night. First time I've been to that. That was a great event, watching the kids go around, getting to interact with the kids, interact with the teachers there and stuff. I just can't say enough about how much fun I had that night, and it was cold that night too. The winter music celebration, you know, orchestra, band, and choir, that was an awesome event that we got to go to in December, and I look forward to that every year. Coming up is the musical The Wiz here at the high school, and it's February 17th, 18th, and 19th. And
it's 24th, 25th, and 26th.
Okay. That's fine.
Slight correction.
That's fine. But again, all the musicians and all the choir and all of that are going to be in that, so let's look forward to that. Then the next two nights, we have basketball at home, and Saturday is the Athletic Hall of Fame induction at the high school basketball game. So that there's a dinner before that, and then they get the induction at the high school game Saturday night. Then also, I just wanted to comment, and it kind of piggybacks with what Jerry said. I always ask everybody, look where we were a year ago, and look where we are now. And hopefully everybody sees a difference, and think forward to where we're going to be a year from now. And a lot of great things to come. So, thank you.
Okay. After all that. I want to say thank you to the administrators for the recognition. It's very kind, very sweet of you to give us these gifts, and it's nice to be recognized. Jerry and Andy, thank you for being such good role models for us. You've made coming on in this first year has been pretty much a breeze. I mean, as we
were talking about those meetings
No, but really, it's been, I mean, we all get along so well, and that makes things go so much easier. With respect to the nomination for Vice President, Mr. Browning, you leave me some big shoes to fill. When I first started thinking about being on the board, I mean, you know, you have thoughts, but Jerry takes it to another level. Your commitment to excellence and the think he's taught me so much by the way he thinks about problems and the way he comes at things about how to treat people and how to show respect and how to problem solve. It's incredible, and I'm appreciative that you're my friend and that you've been such a mentor to me. And I look forward to trying to fill your shoes. So thank you.
I'm sure you will just fine. Yeah. Thank you very much.
So regarding some of the events we went to last month, we had another lovely student staff recognition of the quarter award ceremony. And Mr. North keeps trying to say that it was our idea, but really, it was his.
Right.
And I appreciate that he keeps saying that. But really, it's a wonderful program that you came up with. And I think it's made big strides in the community in terms of being able to show recognition for these kids and families that are doing so well. And the little ones are so cute when they come scampering across the stage. So it's very fun to be able to do that. And we had another great one. So thank you. I'm looking forward to another good year.
I would like to call your attention to, I meant to talk about this earlier, we have changed the time of the board, the regular board meetings, to a half hour earlier at 6 p.m. So the next board meeting will be Thursday, February 2nd at 6 p.m. So, today, Don and I went to Columbus to the Ohio Coalition for Equity and Adequacy Steering Committee meeting, where they're talking about upcoming issues regarding schools, school funding, regulations, all kinds of the craziness that comes out of Columbus. Now, this is one of the main subjects was House Bill 628, which is a 779-page bill that's being in front of the legislature. They don't expect it to pass in its existing state, but they've put in some pretty wild things as trial balloons. One of which is creating a state property tax beginning in the tax year 2018. And that would be for funding primary and secondary education.
prohibiting all school district property and income tax levies beginning that same tax year. So the state would take over and we'd no longer vote on our property taxes. Here's a couple of really scary ones, especially considering what we have going on here. Abolishes the School Facilities Commission, transfers its powers, duties, and staff with respect to in-progress state-funded school building projects to the OFCC, the Facilities Construction Commission, and prohibits any additional school building project from being approved for state funding under any of the programs effective January 2019. And here's another scary one. Replaces district-operated pupil transportation systems with county-wide pupil transportation systems overseen by educational service centers effective January 2019. So that's kind of their crazy thinking in Columbus, not to put it, you know, a damper on things. all of us got these very nice notes from the students at the primary school. It's really, really touching. I've been working with tutoring some of the first graders over there, and it's really interesting to work with them and see that. And I will echo this whirlwind of a year that we've had. So much has been accomplished. A new superintendent, renewing a operating levy, passing bond levy, and now we've got a complete overhaul of our policies coming up and the whole process of starting to do it. So we've got quite a bit going on. So, and I think that's enough. So we'll now move to executive session to discuss investigation of complaints against a public employee and discipline of a public employee. And we expect no action subsequent to the executive session. I have a motion.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes.
Could we also, for the record, identify that in addition to the board, the treasury superintendent, and will be also joined with Ms. Gayhart and Mr. Walker.
Okay. And the attorney?
No.
The attorney. Good. Okay. Okay. I have a motion.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. McCord.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Browning. We are now in executive session. Oh, roll call.
Mr. McCord?
Here.
Mr.